The 90-mile desert in South Australia, situated near the Victorian border, setting for a peacetime desert conquest. And Brecon headquarters, the nerve center of the scheme.
Chance of a third one.
Yeah, we'll give it a go. Good day, Russ.
We've got those tractor parts ready for you now.
Oh, thanks, Noel.
What does it feel like to have a place of your own, Russ?
Not too bad, Bill. Plenty of work, though. Otherwise, good out. This name makes all the difference.
Mr. Gowing.
Excuse me, chap.
Mr. Gowing, I've got Sherwood waiting.
Are you receiving me? Over.
Good morning, Mac. Receiving you loud and clear. Mac, we have a truck of super for you. It's due to arrive at Wirriga about 9. Just a sec, Mac. She's just about to leave now. You see that the truck's back here by midday, please. Over.
Okay, Noel. Can do. Over and out.
Hey, Brian, come on.
Right out. See you later, Russ.
Cheers, man. Me? Yes, I worked 5 years on this scheme, making farms out of desert. A long time, but she's been worthwhile. Well worthwhile. When a bloke owns his own farm, he doesn't begrudge 5 years. This place didn't look much when we came here. Just desert. Not much like the Sahara. Plenty of rain here to keep the scrub green, but, well, it's rubbish. Wouldn't feed much more than kangaroos. No power in the soil. There's a heck of a lot of it. Stunted bush and mallee scrub. Been like that for years.
Scientists uncovered the secret. Missing trace elements. Copper and zinc. Only after years of research and hundreds of experiments did they arrive at the correct formula. Years of endless, patient research work. Thousands of pasture samples from desert plots. Sorting, weighing, checking. The discovery was made by a team of CSIRO scientists in South Australia. Led by David Reisman, they proved beyond doubt trace elements, copper and zinc, correctly applied, restored the power of the desert soil. They had opened up a great primary production potential. But this was a big desert, a big job, demanding large-scale capital resources and skilled administration. Who could tackle it? Under special acts passed by the South Australian and Victorian governments, the AMP Society was enabled to take up large areas of this desert country for development. Survey, analysis, months of detailed investigation, and finally, the decision. Action followed swiftly. In trucks, command cars, tractors, land rovers, machinery. Men and machines. Men prepared to work on the scheme for 5 years before their chance to ballot for a farm came up. Men and machines. The scheme merited and got the very best of both.
Bring them in, Farley. Keep it coming. That's right, now. Whoa, whoa! Now bring it down. Down, down, Russ.
We soon realized this was going to be a big show. It was well mechanized. We got things done smartly. Plenty of hard work and living conditions no bed of roses, but what the heck? At the end of it all, we'd have our own farms on terms we could handle. Mary, my wife, the other women too, dreamt quite a bit about the homes they'd have. Helped to keep them cheerful despite the summer heat and the winter mud. Tractors didn't stay unserviceable long. We kept them moving. That's what our workshops were for. This one's needed for scrub bashing in the morning. She'll be right.
Ground. What about doubling up on the logs?
Yes, that'll be a good idea.
They tried one log for scrub clearing, then two, then three. Good, but not good enough. Then someone had a bright idea. They'd try ship's anchor chain drawn between two tractors.
Whose great idea was this? I think we're in the blasted navy again.
God, it's heavy.
They
worked
like a stinking
hot day to lather things. Ah, quit your mind. What's
your fingers, Russ?
The idea really worked. It cut a swathe 300 feet wide through the scrub. With ship's anchor chain, they were clearing the ground at a rate of knots. Man and his machines changing the face of the age-old desert, soon to restore nature's balance of soil fertility. Deeper and deeper into the scrub their tractors crawled, clearing and opening the desert country, ever widening the field of operations. New, fully equipped bases were formed. Families moved in. Children's bright voices disturbed the desert silence. To maintain communications with headquarters, radio links were established.
VH58 mobile 1 to base, mobile 1 to VH58 base, receiving you loud and clear now, over.
Morning, Mac. Mac, regarding this fire, I think it'll be okay for today. I'll take the radio over on the rover, and we'll meet you down at the southeast corner of the burn, over.
Okay, now, I'll see you on the eastern side at 1 o'clock, over.
Fire can be a potent ally. It can be a dangerous enemy unless kept under strict control. These men knew exactly what they were doing, firing operations on a grand scale controlled with military precision. Wick on, fuel on, stand by.
There goes a roof. Getting too hot. blasted wind spun right around.
Yeah, you better hurry. Hey, Tony, pull out. Hey, pull out. Righto, fellas. Let's get on with the burn.
Find out. Moving nose, Rover.
How are the tires holding, Tony?
They're all right.
Righto, let's go.
Ready and in good shape for plowing. A job well done, planned and carried out by men who knew what they were doing. Good men, good teammates in work or in play.
And of course it wasn't all work. When there was time for fun, we had plenty. Like country folk everywhere, we made our own. Put on a dance in the old wreck hut. Maybe Victor Sylvester would have had a laugh, but we enjoyed it.
Ah, Russ and Mary. Hold it. That's a good shot of Eddie with the squeeze box.
Brecon Settlement was now a well-established base, geared to equip the scheme for speed and efficiency, capable of handling the many technical problems that arose. The men were quick to improvise, for the size of the operation demanded that they should try new techniques. Multiple units were used wherever possible, standard machines altered and adapted. The workshops were kept busy. Chaining and burning completed, the land was ready for the big, majestic plows, their rusty discs silver burnished by the desert soil, cutting the long, straight furrows, tossing the mallee roots up to the surface. Came the levelers to consolidate the soil, sometimes working day and night, preparing the seed beds on a giant scale for the final and most important process of all, soil replenishment and seeding to be carried out in one operation, the materials brought right onto the job. Seed tried and tested on experimental plots. Subterranean and strawberry clovers, lucerne, phalaris, perennial rye, South African feltgrass, the right seed for each area, the best seed money could buy. And nourishment broadcast over the waiting soil to bring a new kind of life to the desert. Man's work was finished, nature's had begun. Even the desert blooms in spring, but this spring, an interloper had come to stay. New pastures in place of scrub, tracing futuristic patterns on the desert plains, where soon man's flocks and herds would graze. Here, sheep and cattle would grow to prime condition, become symbols of the scheme's success, increase the nation's wealth. The first year it was sold, wool grown on the desert pastures brought top prices. Top prices, too, for beef cattle fattened on these pastures.
There's the top set of them, and they show a lot of weight and quality of plates on them, and are they worth anybody get round about 57 pounds and start at five anyway? I did six, four, and a
half. Yes, yes.
Five, three, 15, 5 pounds.
Yes,
five to start again, you're downstairs. Five, and a bit 55 pounds, five, and then the other bit 55, five.
Yes.
Top
No wonder the men who had worked and waited were eager to take over their farms.
Mary and I had waited 5 years for this. Now it was our turn to ballot for a farm.
The house is next.
All set, chaps?
Yes, sir.
Set, Nell?
All set, Bill.
Right, next time. Will you come up and pick your destiny?
Here we go. This is it. The blocks were all okay, but we had our favourite, and we were lucky. Section 65, under to Willaluka.
That's a good bit of dirt, Mary.
That's a nice bit of dirt, Mary.
We had our farm. Only one thought now, out of the hut, into the home. Ours was built by conventional methods. Others prefabbed to hurry things up a bit. We were all pretty excited, following progress, waiting for the day. Finally, it arrived.
Oh, Rush, you idiot! Put me down at once.
Ours wasn't the only one. Homes were sprouting up in the desert everywhere. New farms, new homes, and nice, quiet weekends for Dad. Were the womenfolk pleased? What a change. These were real homes, solid, faced with stone. Garden homes in the desert. You can bet we made them as good inside as out. With modern kitchens, to provide a farmer's meal. All mod cons. No more huts, no more hardships. We had all kinds of sidelines in addition to stock raising. A bloke has to plan for the future. On parts of our land we grew lucerne. Some even barley and other crops. But pasture for stock raising, wool and beef, were our main line. Fat lambs were a good proposition on my place. I'm doing all right, and I can tell you the others are too. We've come a long way in the last 5 years. It feels pretty good to be a primary producer.
The unyielding desert conquered. New production areas created. Land development based on science. Australians with the enterprise to bring it to fruition. This scheme and others which will follow may be depended upon to help materially in the solution of a major world problem.